My name is Vivek Prakash. I'm an assistant professor of physics at the University of Miami. And this is the physics of coffee. Coffee beans are like a granular fluid, like rice or sugar or salt. They are stored in hoppers. And the idea is you want to be able to retrieve them at the bottom. Because coffee is a granular fluid, physics plays an important role in how it actually flows. If you don't design this hopper properly, you're going to have clogs in the system. Physicists have taken these into consideration. So we design the specific angle for incline and the geometry, which is the hole. All of these have been optimized depending on the grain size. So now you have your coffee beans. The first thing we'll do is grind the coffee. We create coffee powder. You have two typical types of coffee, espresso versus drip coffee. You espresso drinkers know that the coffee has to be strong. Now let's get into why. When you make an espresso, you're going to take the coffee powder and then you're going to compact it. This is bound by something called percolation theory. If you compact it more, you need more pressure. This is what makes the espresso strong, because there is a huge pressure gradient driving the fluid, and the fluid picks up small colloidal coffee particles and then comes out on the other end. Drip coffee just relies on gravity. You can easily pass water through and gravity does the work for you, which is more dilute, but still pretty good depending on your taste. So that's the physics behind espresso versus drip coffee. So now we have our coffee and we want to add a creamer. So the cream sinks to the bottom and all the beautiful structures that you see are actually rising plumes. This is the process of diffusion. So in physics, diffusion is basically one substance going and spreading into another substance, but it takes its own time. You can always speed up diffusion by stirring it or giving it energy. Now, for those of you who are fancy, you like fancy drinks like cappuccino or latte, what the barista is doing is taking your milk, steaming it. That means creating a foamy texture. And that foam is essentially air bubbles trapped inside milk. So then once you put it on the coffee, it doesn't sink, but it floats. So there's a layer of creamy foam on the surface. If you do it very, very carefully, you can create some really pretty looking latte art. So there you go. This is the physics of everything related to coffee. As you can see, there is the entire universe inside your cup of coffee. Enjoy.